In today's video, my friend Jessica and I are gonna talk about her and her Chinese husband's love story. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video from Ling Ling. Today I am here in Beijing together with my new friend Jessica. Could you please introduce yourself?
Sure. Hi, I'm Jessica and I come from Indiana in the USA. And I'm married to my wonderful husband who's from Beijing.
And in this video, we are going to talk about how these two lovebirds, they met each other. So get ready for some romance in the air. So let's get started on this video. First, I would like to know, how long have you been here in China?
I've actually been in China for 7 years.
Whoa.
But I've only been in Beijing for 2. I moved to Beijing for my husband.
Aww, this is so cute. Yeah, so let's get started on the story. The first, I remember we talked about this before, so in the beginning you were not in Beijing. Where were you located before?
I was in Henan province. It's in the middle of China, and I was in a city called Zhengzhou, which is the capital of Henan. And I was actually doing various things, including a travel TV show, and I was importing red wine from California. So yeah, there were a lot of opportunities actually out there because there were not a lot of foreigners.
Yeah.
So I had a great time living there, but then suddenly love hit.
And what do you do for love? Well, you do everything, I guess.
Yeah, but first he had to do a lot more.
I love this story very much. Yeah, so yeah, let's just get started. You are in Henan and he was in Beijing. Like, how did you guys even bump into each other?
Yeah, actually I was selling wine here in Beijing. And of course, one of my clients, a girl, was like, oh, do you want a Chinese boyfriend? And I said, no, I don't want a Chinese boyfriend. And she kept pestering me. And she was like, come on, what do you want? I said, okay, if you can find a guy who is tall, taller than me, because I'm 5'9". So, yeah, taller than me and can speak some English because my Chinese isn't that professional. Fine, give him my information. And she did. She found a guy.
She went on a mission.
Yes, actually.
She went hunting.
I didn't know, but she posted an advertisement for me on WeChat.
That's so Chinese, though.
Yeah.
I'm not surprised at all.
And so my now husband saw that advertisement and said, well, I'm tall and I speak English,
he's
kind of.
Very tall, guys. By the way, he's really, really, really tall. Yeah.
So he contacted me, and I at first said no many times. Yeah.
But Mafan, Beijing, Henan.
Yeah, I thought geography and culture and language, but I agreed to go on one date with him. Yeah, and I have a friend that lives in Beijing, so I came to Beijing for him. He picked me up and he took me to a Western restaurant called TGI Fridays, where you order one dish per person.
Oh.
Right? Where, but in China, you usually order...
Western-minded, yeah, or yeah. Like trying. Yeah,
yeah, like in China, you usually order like 5 dishes and you eat a little bit.
Like here and there, mix.
Right, yeah. But... there, he wasn't sure what to do and he was nervous, so he ordered like 8 dishes, like a hamburger and ribs and a full plate of, you know, everything. And so we had a dinner for 5 people. And he was just so nervous, and I think his English wasn't as good as it obviously is now. And he was very nervous, and so after the date, which was kind of awkward, I said, well, what now? What do you have planned? I came all the way to Beijing for this. And he was like, wait, what? I have to, yeah, like I had to plan something. So he has a car and we get in his car and he starts driving and he keeps driving. And then we're almost at the airport. We're driving an hour basically. And I'm like, where are we going? And he was just driving to try and find inspiration because he didn't know what he was doing either.
Oh my God.
And so, and so finally he dropped me off with a bunch of leftovers at my friend's house in Beijing. She's Chinese. And as she's eating the leftovers, she's telling me, oh, he's so generous and he's just really shy.
Yeah.
And why don't you give him one more chance? Yeah. So the next day, it was a Sunday, I went on one more date with him.
Oh.
And it was much better.
Yeah.
But still, I still thought, you know, I live in a different province. He comes from a very different background. I wasn't sure about dating a Chinese guy.
Yeah.
because I just thought it wouldn't work, and also my parents and my family, there's everything to worry about.
And like, do you want to stay here forever?
Yeah.
Or do you want to go home, and what to do, what not to do, and there are a lot of questions.
Yeah. And so I was the one in the relationship that was all, you know, worried about these culture things, but he wasn't at all, and he would, yeah, and he would send me messages on WeChat, just, hey, how's your day? Mm. You know, let's stay in touch. And finally, that first date happened in October, and in December, I finally told him, like, this isn't going to work. Mm. I really don't see this going anywhere, and he was disappointed, but he's like, it's okay, why don't we just stay in touch?
Yeah, stay in touch.
Stay in touch. Keep in touch on WeChat, and he would message me, not too often, but often enough.
Once in a while, yeah.
Yeah, that he just make sure that I was still there. Mm. And so finally I told him as we were chatting on WeChat that I was going to go in June to visit my parents in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And we were going to go on a, my parents and I were going to go on a road trip together.
I love this part.
It's very romantic,
it's
because
very romantic.
Well, at the time, I didn't realize this, but so he has one of his best friends immigrated to Los Angeles from childhood.
Yep.
So he decided to quit his job that he was thinking about quitting anyway, and going to Los Angeles to live with his friend for the entire month of June. So he quit his job, got on a plane, flew to Los Angeles, and then he, while I was there, he said, oh, are you in LA now? I am too. Let's get lunch.
Yeah, surprise.
Surprise.
I'm here too. What a coincidence.
And I told him, like, oh, okay, that sounds good. But, you know, I'm traveling with my parents, so we have to have dinner together. Mm. But this is not like in China, they really consider meeting the parents as this is a done deal.
Yeah, don't do that.
Like if you meet each other's parents, that's marriage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
And so I tried to explain to him, I was like, listen, that's not how this is going to work. Yeah, this is just a friend thing. And he was like, no problem, I get it, no problem. So we go to lunch and he shows up with a bottle of wine for my dad and flowers for me and my mom. Yeah, and so we had a great lunch and my mom was saying, oh, he's so tall and he's so handsome. And yeah, and it worked out. And so I said, okay, you know, I'm going to San Francisco to visit my friend. If you want to take me on another date, why don't you come to San Francisco? And it's an 8-hour drive.
It's far
from Los Angeles. So he rented a car and drove 8 hours to San Francisco to take me on one more date. Yeah, I mean, looking back, if I had known at the time, maybe a little stalkery, but when you put it in retrospect, it's very romantic.
I feel like that's how a real gentleman should be. It's just a new Western modern world is like, nah, you know, I have to pretend I'm not really that interested. I feel like this is like how, you know, it's supposed to be.
Yeah, I really appreciated that he worked so hard. Mm-hmm. Because once I decided I was going to be with him, you know, then I'm all into the relationship.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That was in June, and he came back in July, and I went on one more date in Beijing. I took a train to Beijing. Mm. It's a 3-hour train ride, and we had another date, and then another date.
Yeah.
And then I decided I wanted to quit my job in Henan province and move to Beijing for him. And then the rest is history.
Yeah.
The best part is when he actually proposed to me.
Yeah.
My favorite thing, because a very American tradition is that he has to talk to my father first and ask my father for permission before.
Right. Yeah.
So my father has WeChat. I made my whole family get WeChat a long time ago.
It's just easier. Life is easier like that.
Yeah, exactly. So he already had my dad's WeChat. And so a month before he proposed to me, he video called my dad and asked for his permission. And then when he proposed to me with 66 roses and in the same restaurant he took me on our first date, he, you know, when he surprised me, I was so happy and I was so surprised.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I was like, but you have to talk to my dad. And it shocked me. And I almost cried when he said, oh, I already have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he speaks fluent English now, by the way.
Yes, very fluent. In fact,
a lot, yeah.
I wish that I could improve my Chinese more, but he's so excited to improve his English. We almost never speak Chinese at home.
Yeah, you have to talk more to your popo.
Yeah, exactly.
My mother-in-law
does not speak any English, so she's where I get most of my practice. But she's so sweet.
She's so sweet. I just met her today. Yeah, she's such a nice lady, actually.
Yeah, she's very nice. And
modern, I think.
And her love language, the way that she shows her affection, is she loves cooking. Mm. So she often routinely cooks food and sends it to go for us to eat at our home.
Wow.
Yeah. It's very nice. It's a really great benefit.
I need an IE like that. Yeah, so that was Jessica's, that was a really good story, actually.
Thank you.
Yeah, I really like that. I'm a little jealous. Yeah. I want a story like that. It's really cute.
Well, I'm so glad he made it so romantic, because really none of this was me, so I wish that I could contribute to this. Besides me moving to Beijing for him, that's when, you know, I really decided. Yeah. What I was gonna do.
Well, one thing, when you guys get like children, then they're gonna have like lighter hair, lighter skin, and bigger eyes. So I think you could.
Yeah, that's true.
Chinese beauty standards here. Love makes baby.
That's true. My mother-in-law said to me, "Oh, yeah." Right before you got there, she said, "Oh, you know, if you have a baby, see that baby over there? Yours will be cuter."
Go. That's approval for mother-in-law here in China.
Quite.
Kind of, yeah. That's amazing. Okay, well, thank you very much
for being
a part of this. Please leave a comment below and let us know what you think, and wish her congratulations on your soon wedding, right? Like, you are married, but...
We're married legally, we have not yet. In China, you usually get legally married first, so we already did that, so we're going to have the ceremony pretty soon.
So exciting. Yeah, so please give us a thumbs up for this video, subscribe down below, and we'll see you again very, very soon.
Yeah. Thanks, everyone.
Bye-bye.